The Philippine agriculture sector was a surprising outperformer for the local economy at a time when the COVID-19 pandemic dragged several industries into negative territory. That's why the country's agriculture secretary, William Dar, continues to make an appeal for a higher budget from the national government to allow it to implement crucial reforms and programs aimed at boosting the competitiveness of local farmers.
Whatever is given by government, we will use it to the best. And so efficiencies have to be brought to bear, and good governance, no to corruption, so every peso properly invested. Having said that, of course, we will always aim for a higher budget. Sana mapakinggan po kami ng Kongreso.
The Agriculture Department's budget for next year was pegged at over 66 billion pesos, or 17% lower than this year's near 80 billion. The agency actually asked for 240 billion pesos for 2021 after no less than President Rodrigo Duterte acknowledged the important role of the sector in the country's economic recovery from the COVID-19 pandemic. Amid uncertainties over the department's budget, Dar says they're now focusing on encouraging more private sector investments into the industry. Among the key programs of the agency in promoting more investments in agriculture are building agro-industrial business corridors across the country, starting with the new Clark City in Tarlac Province, north of Metro Manila. The DA also readying loan packages for micro and small agri-entrepreneurs worth 350,000 to 15 million pesos under its Agri-Negosyo program. It's also eyeing to further boost the agricultural export sector, as well as fast-tracking infrastructure projects crucial to the local farm industry. For one, DAR is proposing to the National Irrigation Administration to tap the private sector in helping it accelerate the development of irrigation facilities for 1.2 million hectares of agricultural land.
At the rate government is investing in irrigation systems development, it will take another 20 years bago ma-develop yung irrigation requirements ng 1.2 million hectares. So, I suggested to NIA, because this is, NIA is not under the oversight of DA, I suggested to them na why not go for a PPP build and transfer scheme.
At least one private sector group expressing willingness to boost investments in the local agricultural sector. Christopher Ilagan, Corporate Affairs Director at Cargill Philippines, says these projects should also provide good business sense for companies.
There are modes that could fund irrigation projects if, for example, you're able to incorporate a hydropower component or a municipal water use.
For decades, Philippine agriculture has been suffering a contracting share to the local economy, with farmers struggling to stay competitive amid a lack of government and private sector support. Bruce Rodriguez, ABS-CBN News.